soon as I turn the camera on, it starts sprinkling again. We are supposed to get more rain and snow tonight. And it is supposed to start right about now. Let's see if I can get this segment done first. This tree you see in front of you is a big, giant, old cedar. That's got it well over 100 years old. Well over 100 years old. And it is just a big, beautiful tree. It's not as big as it used to be, because you can see there's a group of branches there that came down. And there's a section of a big branch. And then all of this in here came off of this tree. You can see the hoop coop in the midst of it. Yeah, this is just a giant disaster. Look at all this. And look at the size of that branch that came down off the top. You know, that branch right there is probably 30 years old itself. So this is a complete mess. If I would have had chickens in there, I would have had to have cut a hole in the back of the coop to get them out. That would have been a lot easier than sawing through all of this cedar brush. But this is just a ton of branches came down and crushed my hoop coop. We'll walk around a little bit. And, you know, I just emptied this out of some younger ankle biters. Yeah, you can see the big old divot in there. And the plan was for me to put another flock in here as soon as possible. I've got a big flock in the back with two roosters and a bunch of hens, and I wanted to split that up and put split that up into two flocks and put one of them in here. And then once you do split them up, you've got to wait a month until you can hatch their eggs so that you know who the father is. So, you know, every day I'm not able to split this flock up. It's basically costing me money right now. And yeah, winter, go figure. These would have been not as important for me to hatch and sell as some of my others, but yeah. And then here's another branch. This came off of a smaller, younger cedar tree. And there's still a bunch of branches that are just hanging on for dear life. If we get more rain and ice tonight, they might come down tonight. No more major damage since the snowstorm. So we did get ice yesterday, but it wasn't a big volume of it. But yeah, just completely crushed the hoop coop. And, you know, there's a giant amount of limbs in there that I'm going to have to, you know, grab my chainsaw and my sawzall and my clippers and just have to work my way through it. And then I can get an assessment of this coop and how much damage there is. You know, it's just cattle panels, so hopefully they can be bent back, you know, relatively to the shape they need to be. And I might have to put a reinforcement in the middle or something. But, you know, not sure about the wood supports, you know, like the door. The door might be crushed. I might need more lumber. Yeah, the door looks okay. So, I do have some chicken wire that got ripped up. Yeah. So this is just going to be a ton of work that I don't need to be adding extra work. All right, that's enough for this segment. You know, it's not all bad. I didn't lose any power, you know, other than a few minutes here and there. I did lose internet for a few hours. But that was mostly my fault for not turning the heater on the satellite. Well, it was on, but not turning it all the way to high. But other than that, you know, it could be so much worse. Could be so much worse. This time I didn't, you know, last time, right before Christmas, I lost all water inside the house for, what, 4 days. So, yeah, I'm glad this combined with that didn't happen all at once. That'd have been a real nightmare to lose water and have all this to deal with. But it is pretty peaceful and quiet. They're pretty much all able to come out. There's one lone little boy, and number two's legacy flock was out earlier. Of course, the boys' flock, they're out running around. But everybody is staying inside. It's like they're a bunch of chickens or something. Yeah, that's next on the agenda. I got to start dispersing some hay. So they've got a dry place to walk. Because wet feet and freezing temperatures is not good for their feet. So I'm not going to film it, but I've got, that's probably a couple hours worth of work. Oh, and I better get going. Oh, now you're all getting brave. You think I'm bringing you more food? I am not bringing you more food. My woodshed has become depleted. Yeah. So a lot of those in there are too big for my wood stove. So I need to cut them down or split them or whatever. And other than a chainsaw, I don't have any splitters or anything to split them with. But yeah, so I have made the executive decision to stop using the wood stove unless there's an electric outage emergency. I would hate to use up all my wood and then have the power go out and not have wood. Now, I do have some firewoods, you know, strewn about the property that was cut down before. Yeah, but it's been outside for a year and a half, so it might not be the best firewood. But yeah, for now, I am shutting down the wood stove and saving the last of my wood for an electric outage emergency. Yeah, see, a lot of those are too long for my wood stove, and then some of those are just too thick for it, and then some of them are just too rotted out. You don't want to use a lot of rotten wood in your wood stove, and that's a bunch of cedar, I think. So that's about, you know, I got a good stack of cedar that'll fit in my wood stove. And I could bring the chainsaw out here and get some more. So, you know, I've probably got 3-4 days worth of wood if the power were to go out, if I put in a little bit of effort with a chainsaw. But yeah, that's how it happens. Yeah, there's a pile of potential firewood, and I really could use this space so I can move another flock here in the front yard, bring that other coop way back in the right there. That one's empty right now. I do want to bring it in the front yard, and you can see where the fence ends. I've got a lot of space over in here for another flock. So yeah, I've got a bunch of firewood. It's just, other than my little electric DeWalt chainsaw, it's the only thing I have to. Yeah, buddy, you want me to move that too, don't you? It's the only thing I have to process wood is my little chainsaw. Yeah, that's a white and true blue guy. Yeah, would you talk those ladies into starting to lay more eggs? I got one of you laying in there, but I need more eggs. I know they probably don't listen to you any more than they listen to me, but we can keep trying. All right, blue, black, splash, copper, bronze flock. What do you say you get back in your coop so I don't have to come back out and close you up later? I got to close up the other flocks, but, you know, if you went in there now, that'd be less work for me. Because I'm already out here, and your food is in the door. Go on. Go on. Show them the way, big boy. Everybody inside the coop. No, don't get any ideas. Look at that. Look at that. Uh-oh. Now, maybe we can get this other flock, too. I got to walk around the long way so I don't slide down the hill. Turn around, little white and true blue. Run, run, run. Run, run, run. You get in there too. Go on. You can do it. No, don't come out. Go back in. All right, we got everybody. We got everybody. Good night. Here's a fraternity boys flock. Look at that tree that came down. Just the top half of it just broke off. I was lucky that did not fall into a fence, but yeah, you can see some others did. That's a relatively small branch that came down on my fencing, and yeah, a few more back there that landed on the fencing. And they came from all the way up there on the top of this pine tree. Yep. That's a tall pine tree. And I can show you one of the holes I got. You can see the vertical and the horizontal there. Got busted out. Yeah, and it goes all further over there. So that was a big patch of fence. Ripped. And then here's another section. I just, you know, kind of, because the chickens can get out of those big holes. But there's another section here with big rips in it. And this electric fence will not work until I get these repaired. There's a hole in this one. You can see it frayed, maybe. Yep. And these branches weren't all that big. It's just that they fell from so far up. They ripped two giant holes in this fence. All right, it's a little after 3. Everybody has food and water and fresh, dry hay. And they are all closed up for the night, except for the fraternity boys. So I am done until dark, and then all I need to do is get the fraternity boys so I could go in and get a nice nap in this afternoon. Thanks so much for watching. Thanks for sticking with me and, you know, hanging in there, following my journey out here to do whatever it is I'm doing. I don't even know some days. Thanks for watching. Take it easy, everybody.